Hi there, Mr. Holcomb here with another episode of The Math Behind the Modules. This is lesson one from our new module, module four, the relationship of addition and subtraction. Opening exercise, they ask us to draw a tape diagram to represent 5 plus 4. So I'm going to be really accurate this time. I'm going to draw a tape diagram using two different colors, one for 5 and green for 4. So I'm going to start with my red. And I'm going to make them a half a centimeter in length per square. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will get me out to here. Actually, how about I do, that's too small. So I'll go to there. And I'll change colors and go out to here. Okay. Now I'm going to move. Rotate. So it says 90 degrees. Okay, and I will draw linear. I wanted that red. This might be too tedious to do. Electronic. All right, so now I'm just going to rotate this back and then put this here. And then draw a line out so it lines up with that, and then continue here. I'm just creating a tape diagram. Okay, I think that's good enough for starters. I'll do the rest freehand. Okay. So if we had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 squares, there's my 5 right here. And then if I go to 4, that'd be 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is 4. And there is our tape diagram for 5 plus 4. Now we're going the other way around, and it says to write an expression for each tape diagram. Well, how many is this? 2 plus, and these two is 2. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we add. So this says to write an expression. It didn't say to solve. So 2 plus 2 is an expression. 3 plus 4 is an expression. Okay. Exercise. Predict what will happen when a tape diagram has a larger number of squares. Some squares are removed, and then the same amount of squares are added back on. Okay. So what that means is if I have a tape diagram, it's a large number of squares. So I don't know how many. So let's make a tape diagram and do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 squares. So this is 9. And it says, what would happen if you took a large number of squares? Some of the squares are removed. Okay, so I'm going to take away 3 of them, but then add 3 back on. Okay, so we're taking 3 away, but then adding the 3 back on. Well, what's going to happen? So we're going to have 9, take away 3 is 6, add 3 to that 6, and we're back to 9. Okay? So what we're leading up to here is additive inverses, basically what's happening. And I'll explain it more as we go. It says, build a tape diagram with 10 squares. So that took way too long for me to do with a ruler, so I'll do the best I can freehand. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Build a tape diagram with 10 squares. Check. Remove 6 of the squares. I'm going to write X's for my removal. Write an expression that represents the tape diagram. So if I remove 6, it would be 10 minus 6. Now it says to add 6 squares onto the tape diagram. So now I'm going to take the 4 that I had left over. Okay, these 4 are these 4 here. And now I'm going to add 6 back on. Let me change colors for this. I'm going to add 6 back on. One, two, three, four, five, six. So I took 10 away, so that's 10 minus 6, and I got 4. So this would be, and then it says add 6 squares onto the tape diagram. So that'd be 4 plus 6. So 10 minus 6 equals 4, 4 plus 6 equals 10. So in other words, it says alter the original expression to represent the current tape diagram. So it would be, this is 10 minus 6, so instead of saying 4, we're just going to leave that as 10 minus 6. So if I, this is what they're saying here, we're not going to write it as 4, we're going to write it as the original 10 minus 6. So 10 minus 6 is being represented by these 4, and then we add 6, and we get back to our original 10. Okay, and let's just leave the equals off here as well. So as I said, write an expression, and I'm always very clear about this in class. If it says expression, it doesn't have an equals. So this expression would be 10 minus 6, and this expression would be 10 minus 6 plus 6. No equals 6. Okay, that's better. C, evaluate the expression. So now it says to evaluate, meaning find the solution to the expression. So 10 minus 6 plus 6 equals 10. Now it says write an equation using variables to represent the identities we've demonstrated with tape diagrams. So we can use any variable we want. We could say A plus B minus B. So A is 10, B is 6. So A or A minus B. I mean, that should be minus. It's going in the same order as I did up above. A minus B plus B equals. So A is 10, B is 6, B is 6, 10 is A, so that comes back to A. A minus B plus B equals A. Okay, now using your knowledge of identities, fill in each of the blanks. 4 plus 5 minus 5. Equals 4. So what's going to happen is if we add or subtract the same thing, it cancels and we're left with what we started. So we're adding 10 to this, so we have to take away 10 if we want to start, to end up with where we started. 25 minus 10 is 15, plus 10 is 25. So now we're adding 16 and subtracting 16, which is 0. 45 plus 0 is 45. 56 minus 20 is 36, plus 20 is back to 56. Number 5, same thing. Now we're going to fill in the blank variables. A plus B minus B equals A. Familiar? That was the example I used up here. Right here. B, C minus D plus D gets us back to where we started. If I'm going to take F away from E and still have E, I've got to add that F back in. And H minus H is nothing. Nothing plus G is G. That was a really short lesson. That's record time, I think, under 9 minutes. Go to your problem center.